In today's episode, we're going to go through Active Storage. I'm going to show you how to set it up, how to add it to your models, how to resize images in like two lines of code, and the end result is you get something lovely like this. Let's jump in. Before we had Active Storage, we had gems like Carrier Wave, Paperclip, Dragonfly, and Shrine. And what they all did was just let us upload and manipulate files when we uploaded them to Rails. They were all pretty good, they all had their pros and cons, but Active Storage comes built into Rails, so it's really good to learn, and in most cases, it'll be perfect for what you need to do. Out of the box, it requires a little bit of extra setup from us to get it working in Rails. And it's described here that we have to add two new tables. So we're going to copy this command, and I'm just going to run it. So I'm going to do bundle exec Rails Active Storage install. Awesome. And if we do git status, you can see it's added a little file here. So let's have a quick look at what that looks like. Cool, let's have a look. Okay, looks like a pretty normal migration where it's adding three tables, which all will store information about the stuff which has been uploaded. So I'm now going to run bundle exec. Rails db migrate to run this migration. Cool. If I was to quickly refresh my table view here, we can see we now have those tables available in our database. Active Storage comes with a number of ways we can store our files. For this tutorial, I'm just going to use local. That means it's going to be stored in a folder called storage within our app. But if you're using something like Heroku or any web server, you should probably be storing your files on S3. That is the best one, and even better, mirrored across multiple services. We're going to use this method called has_one_attached_avatar to tell Rails that this model over here, the post one, will have a method called avatar, which we can attach a file to. Let's see it in action. It's a lot easier to see this stuff visually. So we now have this method in here called avatar, which we can mess around with. If we go to our form, we can quickly add a file field in. So I'm going to quickly do that. I'm going to call it avatar. Change avatar. Let's just have a look what this text field looks like quickly. So I'm going to go to edit. We can see that as this is a text field, it's called to S on that avatar method. And we've got this thing saying, hey, I'm an active storage attachment. So let's quickly change that to be a file field. Fantastic, we've got a file field. And we also need to update the controller as well. And this is where I really love this active storage stuff. To add that to this model, put avatar in there, which is the field name. If I was to quickly drop a file into here and click update post, and I need to output it on the show as well while I'm here. Let me copy these. Let's call it avatar. Avatar. There we go, nice. You can see it's outputted an object, which is cool. So if I wanted to see what that was, we know it's going to be an image in this case. Yeah. That's me. That was really easy. You're probably wondering, where on earth has this file just been saved? Well, if we go to our storage config file, you can see it's in the Rails root join the storage. So that means the Rails root and then join the storage folder. So if we go into here and go storage, it's in here. And if we have a little look at that, that's that file we just uploaded, which is very cool. If you upload to S3, it'll follow the same format, which is quite cool. But you're probably wondering, well, what happens to this file if something new gets uploaded? Well, Rails will purge it for you. You can configure this if you want, but let's just see it in action. So keep your eye over here. So I'm gonna upload a new image of myself. It's gonna drop that in, click update post. Okay, so you saw a new file was just uploaded over here. And it deleted the old version. Magic. After you've uploaded a file, Rails will do a very quick analysis of it, and this will be stored in the metadata on the actual blob. You can see it kind of right here. So the way to get this, if you're in terminal, is maybe do bundle exec rails c. We're going to get the most recent post. And we know there's an avatar on it. Okay, we can go blob. That's going to bring us into this table here, the active storage blobs. And then we can do metadata. Sweet, so we now know the width and height of that image very easily. It's very rare you'll ever need to touch this object, but it has some useful bits of information like the content height, width height, that kind of stuff. Let's jump into transforming images, and by this I mean resizing and compressing them. The Rails docs has a little example to get you started, but if you really want to have a good deep dive, I recommend going to the Rails repo and looking at this variant class file, where they have a load of really good documentation right at the top on how to use it. If you really want to deep dive in, have a look at the image processing gem on GitHub. They have these like docs for all the things it wraps. So Minimagic is the thing it's wrapping right here. And you can see all the methods you can pass into it. And it's really handy to kind of do the really fancy stuff. Let's jump into making a variant. Don't worry if some of it goes over your head a bit too quickly. I'm going to write like an accompanying blog post to go with this video where it's going to just kind of give you some really good examples, and then you can play around on your own projects quite easily. So with the variants, we have a little method on here called variant, which is say, hey, take this avatar, do some compression, and let's see how we go. It's a little bit hard to figure out what you can pass into this, but if you go to the image processing library and go to the Minimagic docs, you're going to see a load of methods. These methods get passed in as a key value, and where the key is the method you're going to call, and then the value is the argument you're going to pass to it. So for example, I can go here and go to the saver method, which is going to compress stuff, and I would pass it in like saver. And I can see it's got some name methods here, so I'm just going to do quality. And I'm going to say 30. So we can see here the image is about 24 kilobytes. And there we go. It was just able to quickly resize it on the fly. And what's really cool is now Rails has done that resizing. If I refresh the page again, it's going to store that resized variant in our server somewhere and just return the cached file, which is fantastic. Okay. What if I wanted to rotate this image? You can see on here, we do actually have a rotate argument. The thing which is different from our saver is it was all named arguments in our saver argument. But in here, we've got like the word rotate, and then the first one is a known value. So the way we'd put that in is we'll do rotate, and we'll have an array, and we'll say rotate 45 degrees, and let's make the background. Let's make it like 0f0. I think that's bright green. Let's have a look. Oh, I forgot the comma. Okay, that's quite cool. But what if we wanted a transparent background? That would just say transparent. Now, this isn't going to work initially because we have an image which is a JPEG. So what we want to do there is we want to say format PNG, because PNGs can be transparent. And there we go. Just rotated our image 45 degrees and given it a transparent background. And all it needed was that code there. That's so cool. Our image is kind of big. Let's crop it down a little bit and make it a bit smaller. Minimagic has a couple of methods we can use. And Active Storage uses Minimagic under the hood, so we can just call these. These are the main ones here. I'm going to link to these in the show notes so you can just kind of read up about them. They kind of differ in how they treat the aspect ratio of the image. They describe it quite well in the docs. But let's have a quick look at resize to limit. So in this case, we know there's two kind of fixed unnamed arguments, so we're going to pass them in as an array. And that's going to make a image which is 400 by 400-ish. except in this case, because we're limiting it, it's also going to keep the file ratio the same. So if I wanted to maybe have something where the height was definitely 400, I could also just pass this in as nil, and it would be like, hey, the width can be whatever, but the height will always be 400. You can kind of see there, which is quite cool. If we wanted to make this image exactly 400 by 400, we can use a method called resize and pad. And that's just going to add a little bit of extra space around it. So I'm going to do 400 here. Cool, you can see it's added some nice white background to it. So that's quite nice. Let's tweak this a little bit. What I'd like to do is maybe have it so the image is always at the top of this. Or the actual image where resizing is pushed to the top. The way we can do that is by passing a gravity argument in. And I believe we're going to just do north. North. Cool. Sweet. So there's a bit of gravity up here pulling the image originally. And we get more padding at the bottom. If we wanted to change that background as well, we could pass in a background argument. And I'm going to do 0f0, lovely green color. Cool. Got a lovely green bit of padding, and our image is 400 by 400 exactly. If we wanted to make this transparent, you can do that. However, because this is also a JPEG, we need to change the format to be PNG first. Fantastic. That was a really quick overview of Active Storage. I hope you kind of found it useful when you feel confident to resize images with Active Storage. It does a load more under the hood, like you can preview PDFs as well. If you want to see a video on that, drop a comment below. I'm going to add links to all of the repos like this into the show notes. And I'm also going to have an accompanying blog post probably on Dev2 with a few more examples on how to resize things. Thank you for watching. Please remember to give me a like and a follow on Twitter. I always appreciate those. And I'll see you next time.